Hello students, welcome to your English language course. Today I will be sharing with you techniques to write detailed descriptive writing. Techniques to write descriptive writing. When you're writing to describe, remember that the reader won't have the same picture in their head as you have in yours. So to help them visualize the scene, you need to draw it with your words. For example, I was standing in the ante room. In this picture, you can see that the room is bright and pleasant. Whereas this room looks dark and scary. Use the senses and describe what you can see, hear, touch, taste, or smell. Use literary devices like alliteration. It is a term to describe a literary device in which a series of words begin with the same consonant sound. A classic example is, she sells seashells by the seashore. Onomatopoeia. It is a word that describes a sound and actually mimics the sound of the object or action it refers to when it's spoken, like hee-haw. A metaphor is a figure of speech that describes an object or action in a way that isn't literally true but helps to explain an idea or make a comparison. For example, you are a lion. A simile is a figure of speech that makes a comparison showing similarities between two different things. Unlike a metaphor, a simile draws resemblance with the help of the words like or as. Therefore, it's a direct comparison. For example, her cheeks are red like a rose. Personification is when you give an animal or object qualities or abilities that only human can have. For example, my alarm clock yells at me to get out of bed every morning. Remember, it is not necessary to use every single sense all the time, but combining a few senses will help the scene burst into life. Sight or sound tends to be popular and successful choices. Sight. How things looked. The wall crumbled away to reveal a small tunnel winding into the distance. The puppy was black with the three snow-white paws and no floppy white ear. It had a long tail with white tip. Sounds. How things sounded. As I walked into the room, the floorboards creaked. I knocked into a table and the glass was hit the floor. Crash. Develop the description. As I crept into my grandfather's darkened study, the unwelcoming floorboards began to creak. Clumsily, my legs nudged against the antique table and his precious crystal glass was started to wobble. A moment later, there was a heart-stopping crash. Splinters like a thousand shiny spiders scuttled in all directions across the smooth floor. My heart seemed to explode in my chest while the ticking clock quietly tutted its disapproval at me. Tut, tut. hat. Steps to remember. Begin with interesting opening sentences or the topic sentences that tells what the description is all about. Use exact vivid words to create a picture in the reader's mind. Include important details about what you are describing, but also describe the unpredictable parts of the scene. For example, describe not only the waves, sky, and scent of a seaside, but also describe the smell of a sun cream, etc. Put the details in definite order, spatial order, where things are located in space, like from top to bottom, left to right, front to back, etc. Time order, when an event occurred, like meanwhile, by the time, suddenly, etc. Structure your paragraphs to divide the writing into sections. It is a good idea for a paragraph to begin with a topic sentence. Sometimes, for variety, the topic sentence can be the final sentence in the paragraph. Every time when something changes, develop a new paragraph. When you start writing about a new place, when you start writing about a different time, when you talk about a new person, when you start writing about a new topic, how to end description. The type of ending a writer chooses depends on his or her purpose. When the purpose is to entertain, ending may be happy or tragic, or a surprise ending may provide a twist. Endings can be circular, looping back to the beginning, so readers end where they begin. Or they can leave the reader hanging, wishing for more. Proofread. To remember what to proofread, just memorize this word, cups. C stands for check for capital letters. C stands for capital. Check for understanding. U stands for understanding. Check for correct punctuation. P stands for punctuation. Check for correct spellings. S stands for spellings. That's it for today. Take good care of yourself and happy writing!